Okay, this is an example of calculating the pressure inside a water droplet due to surface tension effects. As you'll see from this example, the pressure inside a small water droplet can become very, very high.
The question asks, what is the pressure inside a droplet of water with a radius of half a millimeter at 20 degrees C? And you're told to ignore the effects of gravity and that the local pressure is 100.3 kPa. So here's the solution. First, we consider a free body diagram on half of the droplet. So what I've shown over here is a free body diagram on the lower half of the droplet. So we've cut it in two, and we've placed the forces at this surface here. So we have two forces at work. One is the pressure force, which acts over the cross-sectional area of the droplet. And that's balanced by the interfacial tension in the droplet's skin. And remember, surface tension is force per unit length. So to get the total force in this interface, we need to take the surface tension times the length of the interface. And the length of the interface is the circumference, so it's epsilon times 2 pi r. So this is just a simple statics problem. The sum of the forces in the vertical direction equals zero. So the pressure force balances the total surface tension force in the droplet skin. As we discussed, the pressure force acts over the cross-sectional area of the droplet, pi r squared here. And the surface tension force, which is the force per unit length, acts over the droplet perimeter, which is 2 pi r. And you can check my algebra here. You can see that if you solve for delta P, you get that the pressure inside of a little droplet of water is 2 times the surface tension divided by the radius of the droplet. So I've reproduced that result here. Delta P equals 2 epsilon divided by r, and you're told in the problem statement that the radius of the droplet is half a millimeter. So now you can go to your appendix, table A5, and look up the surface tension of a water-air interface at 20 degrees C, and it's 0.0728 newtons per meter. And now it's just a matter of making the substitutions. 2 times the surface tension divided by the radius of the droplet, being careful to notice that that's half a millimeter. And you can see that the units work out. Newtons per meter squared is pressure. And we get 291 newtons per meter squared, which is 0.291 kilopascals. So that's the pressure difference between the inside and the outside of the droplet. The inside of the droplet is 291 pascals above atmospheric pressure. The question asks for the pressure inside the droplet. To get the absolute pressure inside the droplet, you want to add on the atmospheric pressure. So the atmospheric pressure, you're told in the problem statement, is 100.3 kilopascals. You add on this 0.291 kilopascals, and I've done a little rounding here. So the answer is that the pressure inside the small droplet of water is 100.6 kilopascals. Now, there's a curious thing about this equation here. You can see, looking at this equation, that as the droplet gets smaller and smaller, the pressure goes up and up, and it can become very, very large. And in fact, as the radius of the droplet goes to zero, as that droplet evaporates and starts to disappear, that equation says that the delta P across the interface goes to infinity. Now, do you think that's reality? Is that what really happens? Take a moment and think about this. Maybe pause the video. The answer is no. The pressure inside the droplet doesn't become infinite. This analysis is based on the continuum approximation. And we talked about the continuum approximation in one of the first videos in this course. As the droplet gets smaller and smaller, at some point, the continuum approximation will break down. So once the radius of the droplet approaches the size of a water molecule, this analysis is no longer valid. So this is just a mathematical singularity because of the assumptions that are built into this analysis.
And that completes this example.